Shake your head!
Get those cookies, get those cookies.
Hi, I'm Analytical, and today we are going to get those cookies, okay? I've been enjoying Miss Vanjie on RuPaul's Drag Race so much, so I decided to throw her into a game with all of her catchphrases. You all on the internet loved it. Miss Vanjie herself even loved it. So let's learn how to build it, because that's really what this channel is all about. Before we dive in, be sure to like the video, subscribe, and ring the bell to be notified of all my upcoming videos. And while you're down there, feel free to grab some of the show notes or check out any of the links I've provided. So let's go. If you're a beginner to programming but still want to make cool things, maybe like a game, one great thing to do is just see if someone's built a similar game. There is a huge community of code on the internet, GitHub on Stack Overflow, and tons of free tools and resources you can use to aid your web development or your game development or your app development. People work together in this community to make it easier to make new technology going forward. So take advantage of it. It's there for the taking. I found this game development framework called Phaser. It provides a ton of features for game development. You get physics, animations, sounds, mobile supported, tons of features that you don't want to have to think about when building a game. You want to focus on telling the story, doing interesting things within a game space. So how do we use this? They provided some getting started material, but it is a little confusing if you are a super beginner. So don't worry, I've broken it all down for you. They say some stuff about a web server that we'll get back to a little later. They have choosing an editor, which we're already using Sublime. We're just going to skip straight to the Hello World. We'll copy this into an index.html file. Actually, we'll call it Phaser Hello World. Hello World is what developers call a first project with something. A Hello World gets you up and started with some of the basics and lets you know some of the important things you'll want to consider when using this kind of library or this kind of programming language. And you don't gotta call it Hello World and be plain. You can call it Ayo Sis, Hello Hun. But if you're looking for the star, someone probably call it Hello World. We're just going to load it into the browser and see what happens. We get the Phaser logo bouncing around as intended. Let's look at what code they gave us. I should also say, I'm not an expert in how to use this program either. So what you're hearing is my thoughts of when I'm looking at a new program, how can I kind of learn what's going on quickly and do the thing I want to do with it. So they gave us just an HTML file. They're including some external JavaScript, and then the only thing on it is the body and the script tag. So the first thing in the script tag is a config, and this is a JavaScript object. We've already gone over string variables, number variables, and even array variables. An object is just another kind of variable. We start out by using opening and closing curly braces. We can throw a semicolon on to end the line. Then we just use a key separated by a colon and then the value. Kind of similar to CSS, except we're going to use a comma to separate each line instead of a semicolon. I know, kind of a pain that all these things have different syntax, but after coding for a while, you will get used to it. What's the worst that's going to happen if you mess it up? The page won't load. We've already seen how to debug with inspect element, and your IDE will also help you out if you get an error. No problems here, and no fear here either. We can use an array in here, we can use in here, we got another key in here, it's giving you the cookies. And we can even have objects inside of object. And here we're gonna go really deep with lots of nested objects. They are very flexible. And you can even put a function as one of the keys. All right, so now let's take a look at the config. And based on what we know about objects, this is pretty simple. We've got a width and height, which is setting the size of the screen. There are some arcade physics in here. And the scene is a nested object. We've got a preload function and a create function, and they're just defined below, so it's a little more clean. In the preload function, we just load in a few images, and they're coming from this base URL, I guess. And it looks like there's also this create function. We're adding the image at a certain location, and then there's some velocity and bounce, which is probably something we're gonna wanna be using if we're making some kind of brick breaker game. So let's go back to the documentation and find some good examples. There are a bunch of different examples you can play with. So go and click them all. I'll have links for all of this below, or you can just explore the website on your own. But let's go to the game section. They've actually got a few games in here. There's Pac-Man, Snake. We're just going to go to Breakout and click through there, and we can... This is really the whole game we're trying to make. We just want to change a few of the images and sounds. So back to that examples directory. They link to where the code is, and they're hosting it on GitHub. I've gone ahead and packaged everything up for this tutorial, so go grab the example code below and you can follow along. I just copy and pasted in the JavaScript code to a separate file. I changed a few things just so we could make sure the assets are in the right location, and I'm including that in the body, just as a separate script so everything is a little more organized, and we'll also get some autocomplete for JavaScript because it's in a JavaScript file. So when we drag it into the browser to see what we get, we don't quite get the game. Well, it works like the game. This is what they were saying about their server earlier. This game library does a few extra things to make sure the game is going to be functioning correctly, pulling in the images, preloading them, pulling in the audio, preloading them. So it just needs a little server to do that. I'll show you exactly how to do that. You'll just need to download Node quickly, and then we're going to install live server. Let's go open the terminal, because that's where we're going to run this command. Start by writing cd to change directory, and then you can just drag in your folder if you want to go to that right directory. Once you're in there, just run npm install -g live -server, and the command and all this information will be below. Run live server, make sure you're in the right directory. One of the great things we have with running this live server is the web page is going to refresh automatically, and it should automatically open a new window with the new game totally working, and we gotta make this a little more gay. But first, let's see what the code we have is. We start out again, we're looking at the bottom, and there is this config object, and it actually looks pretty similar to what we have before. So let's check out what this breakout variable is. There's some stuff with a class here, and new class, and just ignore that for now. It's a really just a function that's being passed an object. It's kind of a big object. We can zoom out a little bit to see how big of an object it is. It's just an object with a set of functions. And Phaser is going to run some of these functions because of their specific name. So preload will get called when it needs to preload, and create will get called when it needs to create. It's doing most of the work for us already. So I'll bring our attention to the important functions, important part of this. So basically starting out, we've got the preload function. And instead of just loading in every image individually to make things faster, they'll put all the images in one image, and then have a separate file that says this part of the image is here, this part of the image is here, and then you'll use that. And this is really common with game development. Breakout.png has all the images, and breakout.json has all the information. But you'll notice JSON is just another JavaScript object, but we can see it's saying the ball is 452 pixels to the right, and then 2 pixels down, and then it's 22 pixels wide and 22 pixels tall. We'll get back to this once we're done reading through all the code. Then we've got a create function, and they've added a few nice comments here, so we can see what each line is doing. So this first one we see is set bounds collision. So each parameter might be disabling certain walls or enabling the bounds of this game. If we change that last one to true, let's see what happens then. So the game seems to be working as normal, but then instead of dying when the ball hits the floor, it just keeps bouncing around. So the game is basically just going to play itself. Then we have got a few lines that are adding the group of bricks. And this is definitely a complicated function. There's a lot going on here. But what if we just change a few of the numbers and see what happens? Instead of making it 10 by 6, we can just make it 5 by 6. Or instead of making these all different colors, we can just make them all purple. Then we're adding the ball and also the paddle. We'll skip these colliders for a second and then go to the input events. We've got pointer move, which tracks your mouse position and maps that to the paddle. So when you're moving your mouse left and right, the paddle follows. What do we want to change it to just move up and down when you move the paddle? I don't know. It's kind of silly. The final thing we want to check out here is these hit brick and hit paddle. In the colliders, when the ball and bricks collide, the hit brick function is run. And when the ball and the paddle collide, the hit paddle function is run. I think we've got through enough of this code for now. Let's turn it up. But on your own, I want you to go play around with this code, comment a few things, and see if there are cool interactions you can make happen. And if there are parts you don't understand, just try changing them a little bit and see what happens. Tinkering around like that is a great way to learn more and level your coding up. So let's first load in a new image. So we're going to load in the ball, and then in this add image, instead of getting the key from assets ball 1, we could just change this to be the Vanjie ball. And let's refresh. Actually, we don't even have to refresh. Live server will do it for us. And Vanjie up here. We are getting closer to the game. Let's open one of the cookie boxes. I edited a few images of cookie boxes to be the right size for this game. If you're following along, it's already included. And for the bricks, we're just going to do the same thing. We'll just throw the key as cookies 0. And now we've got a whole line of Oreos. Cookie Monster is hungry. What just came over me? So now instead of just one cookie, let's set up the whole grid of cookies again. So we've got cookie 0 in, but we want to get cookie 0 through 4 in. Instead of typing it all out manually, let's just do this in a loop. And I'm just going to introduce the for loop here. This will execute a command a given number of times, and it has a variable that keeps track of what number you're on. We'll start it at 0, and while it's less than 5, so all the way up to 4, we'll just keep increasing it. And then to run whatever we're doing, we'll put it in the curly braces. Now instead of 0, we're just going to use I. And each time this runs, we'll add cookies 0, 1, 2, etc. Now in the key, we've got all these new cookies we can add, so let's throw them all in. And now we've got all the cookies. Nabisco is quaking. They wish they could sponsor a video this good. Hashtag not sponsored. These cookies are overlapping a bit because I made them slightly bigger than the previous brick. So let's just increase that size, and because that's going to get a little bigger, let's just decrease how many are in each row. Now Miss Vanjie is getting all of her cookies. Let's also load in audio. And we've done audio before, but if we use the audio built into Phaser, and they have documentation on how to do that. If you're on mobile, sometimes there can be a delay when playing audio due to network, due to different browsers. So Phaser has taken care of all of the mobile audio for us. So we can just load it in just like an image. Let's load in, get those cookies. And then every time we hit a brick, we can play that.
Get those cookies, get those cookies, get those cookies.
That might be a bit much. Maybe we'll just do that one at the end of the game each time. But like a good queen, I've put in the work. I created 18 sound bites of Vanessa Vanjie Mateo. You're welcome. So let's load them in just like we did the images. We're going to use a for loop again and just use the audio this time. And I got 18 audio files and they go all the way up to 17. And we're starting all of these at zero because it's very programmer chic to do. So now we've got all those audios loaded in, and each time we hit a brick, let's just play a random one. So we'll do sound.play, audio plus some random number. And we've gone over how to do a random number before. You can grab this from Stack Overflow or just copy it from the code. So let's see how this goes.
Shake a head!
Who are you talking to, Vanjie?
Later, bitch.
Later, bitch.
Shake a head! Oh! Later, bitch.
Sometimes I have way too much fun with myself. Honestly, we're done here. We've got our cookies, we've got our audio, we've got our Miss Vanjie as the ball. Really, everything you need to make an amazing game. There are some differences between this and the final product, but I'll include the final code, and you can use that as your exploration to do some code tinkering as well. Most of what I did really was just to make it look good on mobile with a bunch of CSS. I added all the social media tags. I've got videos for how to do all of this, so I'll link those below in case you're new and don't know how to do those or don't know what they mean. And then I just added my advertising, because if you're not self-promoting, you are not doing drag. That is all for this video. So thank you so much for joining me. Don't forget to like, subscribe, ring the bell. You know the deal. Goodbye.